God is all the glory and the honor. Lord, we lift our hands and worship you as we bless your holy name. For you are great, you do miracles so great. There is no one else like you, Kashulemanda. There is no one else like you, for you are great, you do miracles so great. There is no one else like you. There is no one else like you. Abba, Father, we just want to thank you. Blessed be God. Thank you and thank you and thank you. For another day in your presence, Lord, we glorify your name. Open all the airways. Let the word go expressly and hit its target. In the name of Jesus. In Jesus' name I pray. And the people say, Amen. Hallelujah. Let's quickly go straight to the Word of God. I welcome everyone today for connecting and those who are going to watch us later. I trust the Lord that this message will be a blessing to you in the mighty name of Jesus. We live in a very end time that people are confused. They don't know what to do or where to go to. But God have sent us to bring a word of encouragement that you can as well win the battle of life in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Hallelujah. Now I'll be preaching on the message titled, Battle Leads to Glory. Battle leads to glory. As a matter of fact, without a battle, there's no glory. Every glory today have a story. You can't just see a man who is up there and you think he just get up there overnight. No, there's a story behind it. There's a story behind it. So when men fight battles and become victorious, now what you see, literally you see, is the victory, but you don't see the battle, the fault. Hallelujah. And so today I'll be looking at the message titled, Battle Lead to Glory. And as I take my text on the book of Luke Gospel, look at it in your Bible. Luke Gospel chapter 4. Now begin to read from verse 13. And when the devil had ended all the temptation, he departed for him for a season. He departed Jesus now. The devil departed for a season. So the devil never leave you alone permanently until you knock him out. If you think you pray for 1 hour, 2 hours, or 1 week, or 1 month, and survive it throughout your life, you are joking. You are joking. Because 1 month prayer cannot survive your lifetime. You can be on fire for this month. You can be on fire for 2 months or 1 year. And the devil can leave you for a season. But what it does is that because you are too hot to handle, he's going to see how he can calm you down. Because maybe some of you have seen prosperity or wealth, and because of that, you can't pray anymore. So he will leave you for a season, waiting for the appointed time to target and hit. We need to understand that. He said he left him for a season. In verse 14, and Jesus returned in the power. I love that. Kapoyata. And Jesus returned in the power of the Spirit into Galilee. Why? Because he conquered the battle at the mountaintop. So he returned back to Galilee. The way he went, he didn't come back the same thing. You see, hear me. I've been to mountains several times. There is no way you can go to a mountain and come back without having an encounter with God. Even though if you spend just one night, you must have an encounter with God. The mountain that normally goes to, it takes you 1 hour to climb to the top. So that stress alone, you'll be praying as you are going. So you cannot step down without a proof. And Jesus came with speed into Galilee, and there went out a fame of him throughout all the region round about. He conquered the battle, so the glory is not showing. The fame went before he went to the mountaintop. His fame is not well known, it's not well amplified. But when he came back for the mountain, his fame went round about all the region. Verse 15. And he taught in their synagogue, being glorified of all of them. They couldn't give him a chance to teach before. They taught himself, well, still a young boy, a young man they can look into. But when he came, they opened up the synagogue for him to teach, for him to express himself. Hear me, until the world we live in today, until you become successful, no one recognizes your effort. I was speaking to a friend yesterday, and we were talking. I say it is only those who are successful, they think they are smarter, those who are not successful. No. Time and chances happen to them all. When you are not successful, anything you say, they say, forget about him. If he knows it so much, why is he not succeeding? But at times, life is not like that. At times, it could be a timing. There could be a time in the season. It is not everyone who enter university that graduate the same year. Some of them may repeat. Some of them will graduate, they may not have a job. Some of them who repeated, they may come and become the best student and have a good job. So time and season happen to them all. But God is the judge of them all. You need patience and persistence in a battle of life before you can win sometime. You need patience and persistence. You keep persisting until you win the battle of life. Jesus was given a parable. Let me show you. He was given a parable. A woman who was persistent in prayer. In Luke chapter 18, verse 1. And he spake a parable unto them to this end, that men ought always to pray and not to faint. And I begin to say, look at what it was saying. There was a city, a judge, who feared not God, nor regarded man. This judge does not fear anybody. But yet this woman wants to win the battle. And there was a widow in the city, and she came unto him, saying, avenge me of my adversary. And he would not for a while, but afterward he said within himself, though I fear not God nor regarded man. Now this is the key saying in his heart. Because of the persistence of this woman, because of keep going. And look at what he said. Yeah, because this widow troubled me in prayers, and we avenge her, lest by her continual coming she weary me. Now this widow woman was persistent in the place of prayers. He goes today, place a demand. Most time it is not your first application you apply on a job that you get a job. Most time you apply for one or two people, Most time it may not be the first school you apply for that they will take you. So life is all about persistence. You need to be persistent with patience. But as long as you don't give up, you will finally gain victory that will lead you to his glory. Because victory lead you to God's glory. That people can see God's glory in your life and say, this must be God. This cannot be a human effort. There are some achievements, there are some breakthrough, there are some level you get to, even at your age or whatever, they can assess you they can use any parameter to measure it or not that. They will say, no, this cannot be the strength of this man. It must be of God. That is where God takes the glory. And I see you that you're going to overtake those who are ahead of you, and God himself will take the glory. It's not the number of years you are working. No. God is going to elevate you, take you to the upper, to the zenith of your life, that only him will take the glory. That you can look back and say, this must be God. He said, when the Lord delivered for the captives or enemy, he said, we are like them that dream. Yesterday, we are in their captive, but today we are free. We are a free man. Battle lead to glory. Always know that life itself is a battle. Life itself is a battle. When you go to bed, it's a battle. How are you going to wake up? It's only God that wake you up, not your alarm and all that thing. So life itself is a battle. When you set up in the day to go for your normal routine job and all that, it is a battle. You go and come back, you've gotten a victory already. Hallelujah. Sometimes God will allow us to go through all manner of battles. Not that he orchestrated it, but he will allow us to go through a man of battle in our life without human assistance, so that when you are done through, you himself get the victory. Because at times when you enter the battle and a man comes to assist you, you will give the man the glory. When you couldn't pay your rent and you want to talk to one or two uncles and the military give you the money to pay the rent, I mean, they will take the glory. But when everything is gone, disappointed you, and you go back home and say, oh Lord, you need to prove yourself. And a strange man or a strange woman just put a call across to you, or somebody they walk to you and say, the Lord says you do this to you. No man can take the glory. It must be God. Most time, people who have sown seeds into our ministry, into our life, I didn't expect them to sow, because probably I've forgotten about them. I don't even. They will just wake up from the blue moon and say, "The Lord said I should drop this seed into your hands." That is where God comes in and take the glory. No man can take the glory when God finished promoting you, finish doing everything you need to do concerning your life. He himself takes the glory. Not man. So that you know that your strength couldn't do it. It is God only that made you to achieve it. Hallelujah. I love what in 1 Corinthians chapter 15 verse 57. He said, but thank be to God which giveth us victory. Which giveth us victory through all our Lord Jesus Christ. Thank be to God. It is not man that gives us victory. Thank be to God who gives us the victory through Christ our Lord Jesus. He gave us the victory. When you enter the battle and you come out, it's victory. You see, you cannot enter the battlefield so pompous. And I say, no, don't worry, I'm going to, it's a workout, I'm going to win him. No, unless it's a WrestleMania, WWF, whereby they know who is going to reign for 1 or 2 years or 3 years, it's easy. But when you enter into a boxing game, that is, you need to be, you, especially if you're a Christian, you need to believe God. To win a battle. It may not be your stature, may not be your talent, but when God is with you, you win. Say to yourself, I am a winner. Hallelujah. David looked at Goliath. He said, who is this uncircumcised Philistine that have come to defy the armies of the Lord? Now looking at David and looking at Goliath, they couldn't march. But David put his trust in the Lord. He said, in the last word that came for the mouth of David, he said, you come to me, cursed by your God, but I come to you in the name of the Lord of Israel. He will give your flesh to me. This battle you are facing right now is going to lead to victory. It will lead to testimony, I'm telling you. It will, when you come out of it, you're going to celebrate. It looks as if all strength is gone. Bible says, weeping men endure for the night, but joy cometh in the morning. I declare that your joy is coming this morning in the mighty name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth. Joy cometh in the morning. Battle lead to glory. Hear this. After Jesus winning the battle of his temptation, Jesus returned to Galilee in the power of the Spirit. Notice that Jesus Christ went through the battle before he could stand and preach in the synagogue, before he could confront the Pharisees. What you are going through now will not kill you, but it will lead to your glory. It will lead to your glory. We need to encourage ourselves. We need to, especially this time, a lot of people have lost their job because of what happened last year. A lot of people have even have lost properties and cars. Because when you cannot be in a developed world, when you cannot pay, when you don't have a job, you cannot pay your bond anymore, you cannot pay your car anymore, they may take it. We live in a world today that nobody, they won't listen to your explanation. You say, you know, I don't have a job anymore, that's why I've not paid for this bond, I've not paid for this car. They will take it after 3 months or so. But God is still God. So you must have to be encouraged that God will never leave you. No matter what you are going through, no matter the pressure, no matter what men have said about you, God is God. Never give up, never throw in the towel. Hold on to the ark. Hold on to the ark. As far as you can hold on to the ark, hold on to the rope, you'll be pulled out. Never let go of the rope. Because the rope is your hope for safety. The rope is a hope for your hope for victory. So hold on to the rope. He will pull you out of what you're going through. Hallelujah. Now, Romans chapter 8, verse 35. He said, who shall separate us from the love of Christ? And then they begin to mention it. He said, shall tribulation or distress or peril or persecution or famines or nakedness? As it is written, for thy sake we are killed all day long. We are counted as sheep for slaughter. But he said in verse 37, he said, but nay, in all this thing we are more than conquerors through Christ that loved us. And I begin to say it in verse 38, for I am persuaded, I am sure, with assurance, I am determined that no height, no depth, nor any other creature shall be able to separate us from the love of God, which is in Christ Jesus our Lord. Hallelujah. Don't be afraid of battle, because once you overcome that battle, victories and glory becomes your new name. Every great person you see today has gone through one battle or the other in life. It is what is that testimony that people see. There is always a testimony after a successful battle. No prize without a fight. No prize. They don't give you fight. You must fight for it. They don't give you the prize. You must fight for it. In other words, prize are only given to those who win. I am a winner. Hallelujah. I am a winner. Hear this. Battle will help us to strengthen our faith in the midst of challenges. Battle will help us to strengthen us, to strengthen our faith in the midst of challenges. You are a winner. Have it in your mind. You are a winner. Remember the song of Jackie Khan who sang, he said, no matter the battle I've come upon against me, I am a winner. I win. That's what he says. I win. No matter what it comes, I win. You must have that mentality in your mind that you are a winner. Now, hear this again. Battle will help us to build and develop our spiritual capacity. These are the things that battles help you to do. Number two is battle will help us to build and develop our spiritual capacity. Number three, battle help us to achieve spiritual authority and power. When you overcome, it gives you authority and power to overcome. Battle can make us gain wisdom and avoid future mistakes in life. When you see people who have gone through battle, they graduated, it's another school, wisdom. You can't make the same mistake twice. So battle help us to gain wisdom and avoid future mistakes in life. Praise Jesus. Another one again, battle will help us to assess the strength and the weakness of our enemies. And you say, well, if I can overcome this battle through 3 days prayer, 3 7-day prayer, I know no matter what's going to happen. You can be to know the kind of prayer you need to pray each time you face with a battle. It helps us to assess the strength and the weakness of our enemies. Again, battle are there as opportunity for our spiritual promotion. Is there. Most times as an evangelist, when I go for a crusade and I see a man of things and maybe during healing and some who don't heal, it was a battle. I go back home and I say, Lord, what is going on? I increase on my prayer. I increase on my days of my fasting. So when I see such a situation, I could gain advantage, but knowing what to do. He said, this kind goeth not except through prayer and fasting. So battle will help you to gain a spiritual promotion. When David won the battle against Goliath, he was promoted and recognized. When Jesus won the battle after 40 days, his ministry began with power, signs, and wonders falling. Bible says in the book of Acts chapter 10 verse 38, you see how God anointed Jesus Christ of Nazareth, who went about doing good, healing all manner of diseases, for God was with him. Paraphrasing it. Battle can help you to gain spiritual authority. God is aware, hear this, God is aware of every battle facing us today, and he will never leave us nor forsake us. This pandemic that is going, it looks as if the world is going to come to an end. It's not time, if it's not time yet for the world to come to an end. God knows. He will never leave us, nor forsake us. It is your time and your season to manifest. It is your time to say, oh God, where? You see, one of the things that trouble man, when will this end? When will I gain victory? When will I see your glory? So Moses said, show me that glory, Lord. When will I see? They long to see his glory. I long to see your glory. Show me that glory. I promise you that God, if you hold on to the rope, there is hope. For God will show you his glory. What I let you know, I want to let you know, hold on to the rope. Because there is hope. Because you will be put out to safety. Matter what men are saying right now, you are a winner. The only person who could be strange, because the Bible says the prosperity of the wicked will kill him, is those who don't know Jesus. And that's one of the reasons why I came. You need to surrender your life to Jesus. Because if you are in the camp of the enemy, there's no way you can fight against them. They will kill you. They will take you as breakfast. But when the blood of Jesus is speaking for you and I, we have boldness. We have boldness to appear before his throne. Going to say, dear Lord Jesus, I am a sinner that need repentance. Have mercy upon me. Devil, I reject you. Jesus, I belong to you. I confess with my mouth and my heart. Believe that you died and rose up on the third day. Thank you for saving my soul. In that mighty name of Jesus. Now bow your head though. If you've taken that prayer, bow your head down and let me pray. Father, I thank you and bless your name. I cover this one with the blood of Jesus. I decree and I declare that the devil have no hold over them anymore. In the name of Jesus Christ, give them strength to overcome whatever difficulty, whatever thing that the enemy has planned for them. In the name of Jesus, I bless you. Bless the Lord. In Jesus' name. Congratulations. Congratulations for taking the decision, this giant decision I've done over the years. And I'm not regretting it. I believe God that it's your new season. Write today's day down that today's the day you give your life to Jesus. And please go to our website and write to us so that we know that you give your life to Christ. And this telecast, we're going to actually send you some material that will help you live a good life. Hallelujah. God is with you. Now, as we bring this telecast to close, I want you to just consider sowing a seed or giving an offering to this ministry. If the Lord lays in your heart, begin to pray that, Lord, what are a hushed man that the Lord is laying in my heart? Right, that our banking details is going to appear on the screen right now. Please follow those banking details. If you're living in South Africa, use those bank. The banking details, the Standard Bank. If you're living in Nigeria and West Africa, some part of country in West Africa, you can use Guaranteed Trust. But if you don't live in this region and you want to be a blessing to this ministry, all right, you can go to our website and go to Place God Donate. Follow the instruction, make a commitment, either once of commitment or monthly commitment. Trust God as we receive your seed. We pray and I believe God that your harvest is guaranteed. You will not lack anything. That the much is again. Now yet it is not the volume of the money or the offering, it's the heart that God look at. You can give $1 million and God say, no, this I rejected the offering. There's no harvest. Or you can give even $100 and God say, no, God will open up the door that will bring millions to you. God will bless your offering in the name of Jesus. Now, before we close, please go to Google Play Store, go to Amazon. You're going to see our books there. Just pick one of them, or you can even buy all of them. All right? And just begin to read. Because we're living in a time whereby you need information to live. We have books on healing, we have books on deliverance, we have books on motivation, how you can make it in life. So you can just gather them, read them, and I trust the Lord that will be a blessing to you. Hallelujah. But hear this, no matter what matters, know that the same God is still alive and he will guarantee you victory. I said to you, cha-cha, and I'll see you again. God bless you. Shalom.